guys have a smoke detector in your house, it's of course gonna be useful. But outside of the house, it's gonna be useless. It seems broken. I'll be seeing you guys later. Bye! Some may ask, what is the alternative? And I will answer them with IoT. Others will ask, what does IoT stand for? And I will answer them, IoT stands for Internet of Things. Second of all, what will we do with IoT? We will be collecting data from sensors that so conveniently come from IoT. Then we will be sending that data to the internet. Afterward, what any normal man or woman would do with that data is act on it. And let's get right into it. Come on, chop chop. Guys, this is what we created. This is a program that basically detects the temperature outside and to where it consists of micro bits, IoT bits, and of course we can't forget the temperature sensor. And also, whenever this turns on, let's turn it on. Let me explain to you why all the Wi-Fi connects. So, to where this will be sensing the temperature. If it's 30 degrees or above, it will be sending us an email right here. Yep. And now, let's see if it's connected. Now, let's try and see if it will work. So, if we put my hand here, then if I close my hand around it, as you can see, a new email just occurred. This new one that's at the top, to where it's explaining to us that outside is 30 degrees and above. Let's try that again, as you can see right here. And now let's wait for it a couple of seconds. Oh, and I just forgot something to mention, to where these emails not, to where a new email just came. Well, many more just came as well. And let me give you a quick review about why they came. To where, if you can see the temperature sensor right here. Whenever the temperature sensor detects that the temperature is 30 degrees or above, it will be sending us a email. And as you can see, we received a couple of emails of them saying that the temperature is 30 degrees or above. Guys, here are the three platforms that we use to make the project. First one is MakeCode. Second one is ThinkSpeak. Third one is IFTTTT. You heard me right, IFTTTT. I can't really do anything about the name, it is pretty weird, but hey, we gotta go with it. First of all, in MakeCode, this is the code that we created on MakeCode. Yup. And of course, this is the code from the start. In the beginning, it's going to be connecting to the Wi-Fi, so SSID means Wi-Fi. So make sure your Wi-Fi is connected and not the one that I already have on screen. Of course, second thing is to where we have the API key. API key is one of the most important parts of this, to where if we go to ThinkSpeak, ThinkSpeak will be giving us the API key. And what this code will be doing is be collecting the temperature from the temperature sensor and we'll be sending it to ThinkSpeak. Now if we just quickly check what we have been receiving from ThinkSpeak, if we go to channels, then my channel, then if we click on microbit data, then if we scroll right down here, we'll be finding that all of the temperature that we recorded, all the temperature that we measured will still be collected here. So we can check all of this out, which is really cool and all. If we did not have IFTTTT, all this would be doing is collecting the temperature and being like, yeah, dude, I'm totally fine. Let's just collect the temperature and let's go on our day. Except, we do not allow that here. To where we use IFTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTTT Stuart's gonna be calling it, being like, hey, HTTPP, we got some problems over here that we needed to fix. To where what this will be doing is going to be sending a message to IFTTTT, and then IFTTTTT will be sending an email to us. It's a very complex system and all, but hey, it all goes up working up to exactly how we want it. To where what IFTTTT stands for is if this, then that. For example, if the temperature is 30 degrees or above, then we send it to that email. And of course, in the email, if we just quickly click on this, and of course, we have two things here. First of all, the webhook. What the webhook does, sure, it's gonna be waiting for the call from ThinkSpeak, like this. Hey, webhook, we've got a problem here. You better send it over to the email. And that's exactly what the webhook is gonna do. Send it to the email. And ho. Email is not the only thing we can possibly do here. If we click on create, wait a second. Then if we click on if this, we click on add, we can do so much more. Of course, we just scratched the surface. I don't even think we scratched the surface with just doing the email. We can do this whole entire list. Yeah, this whole entire list. For example, we can do it with YouTube, Cole, many more to go. Sure, we just only scratched the surface of what we can possibly do with IFTTTT. And of course, again, make code, ThinkSpeak, and IFTTTT, which is all we need to make our own project. Really simple, really easy. Just takes a couple of steps. And of course, IoT can be used by these three platforms. And of course, this is the first time we ever created an IoT project using the IoT kit and Microbit. And of course, this is so cool and awesome because IoT is basically a one-way ticket to controlling the world. Well, the electronic world. And of course, I'm going to be creating a blog for you guys to basically make this project on your own, except the blog will be much simpler than what we just did. And of course, a link will be down in the description below for you guys to get the IoT kit. And let's see what else we can do. Maybe even next time we'll use Cole other than email. Could be pretty cool. Could be pretty awesome. That's it for the coding part of today's video. Just please don't leave yet. We have some more left. Of course, drop a like if you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe while you're at it. And if you guys don't want to miss any new videos, click that notification bell. And yeah, I guess that's it for today. Bye bye. I'll see you in another video.